today we're going to take a look at the eSun carbon fiber PA filament. And recently did a review on this on the channel in our last video. In that video, it was a review of the Bambu Labs carbon fiber filaments. And to have some comparison, we included the eSun carbon fiber PA. It's a nylon carbon fiber filament with about 20% carbon fiber in the filament itself, according to the website. It's a 1.75 millimeter filament. In my last review, we took a look at this filament, did some test prints in comparison to the Bambu Labs, and we got some bad results. Those bad results were mainly due to the type of testing that we were doing. So in that test, in that video, the goal of that video was to take some of the carbon fiber filaments that Bambu Lab has released, to print them out and to get an insight into how they look with just a basic print. We had a mechanical part, a print in place mechanical part, and we also had a assembly, a mechanical part. And the idea basically to see how they worked out and did they print well? Did they fit together well? Did the carbon fiber print in place parts, did they move? Did they have strength, etc.? And it wasn't meant to test all the possibilities of each of those filaments. It was mainly just to give a quick overview of those filaments, although it was a 40 plus minute video. So in this video, I want to take a little bit more in-depth review of the ePA-CF filament from eSun. In my last video, I did say that it was landfill. I think that was slightly unfair. And again, it was just an off-the-cuff comment. So I wanted to give it a proper chance, maybe go out and find out what settings it will print in, because from a cost perspective, it is half the price of the Bambu Lab filaments. But also, I wanted to bear in mind the fact that a lot of people who buy these filaments do just want to see what they look like, how they operate. They're not going to spend ages doing test prints and loads of filament to do test prints to try and perfect the settings. They're going to try and print off something. So they're more likely to go with the default settings, and I wanted to show what those default settings look like. And with those default settings, with that basic drying, the results were not great. And we have them here. You know, this was undried. This was just very flimsy. Wasn't really up to much. And, you know, detail just was non-existent, which is what we'd expect from undried filament. And then as we moved to a dried filament, which had received 8 hours of drying, you know, again, it wasn't a great print. It was very flexible and didn't come out very well. So obviously I made that comment and said that it was landfill because I didn't see much use for it with those default settings. So with that said, I received some comments in the last video. People who've used this filament have gotten good results from it. So I wanted to give it a second chance, maybe go into a little bit more detail and see exactly how do we get those results and how do we improve the prints. So with that said, we'll take a look at my results, how they went, and we'll take a look at the filament itself and see where we go. So before we get started, these are just basic user tests just to see how to get a relatively decent print out of it. I'm not testing strength. I'm not testing any of the properties of the filament. It's merely just testing the printing of the filament and the results from the printing of the filament. So if you want engineering tests, there's plenty of great videos out there that people who do a much better job than I do with that kind of thing. And I'll leave it to those experts to do that. And we'll focus in purely on the printing itself. This is the raw filament. It's just a sample of the raw filament. So firstly, let's take a look at the diameter of this filament. It's a 1.75 filament with a 0.03 accuracy. So measuring the filament, we're getting relatively consistent measurements, all well within the 0.03 So the consistency of the filament is pretty good, and that obviously helps with printing. It means that the printer, when it's pushing through the filament, is getting a fairly consistent flow of filament. So that's a good thing. So based on the feedback and some of the comments that I've read, the general consensus is that this product needs a lot of drying, and that drying is very critical to it. Now, it got the same amount of drying in my tests as the Bambu Labs filaments, but that didn't seem to be enough drying. So I did a number of things to test this out. Firstly, I put the filament into a dryer for 24 hours. I put it on its maximum temperature. Now, its maximum temperature in the dryer was about 50 degrees Celsius. 50 degrees Celsius is not necessarily enough for these types of filaments. Realistically, I think the general consensus is 80 degrees Celsius is what you need to dry these types of filaments. So I put it in the dryer for 24 hours to absolutely dry it out, and then I put it in the AMS, which has desiccant in it and has a 10% humidity, and I ran some test prints. Now, what I found when I ran those test prints is that the drying was fine when I put it in first, but very quickly the filament started to act up again, and I started to get bad results with the filament. So I took it back out of the AMS and I put it back in a dryer, and I left it in the dryer for another 24 hours. And then when I did my printing, with it in the dryer and the dryer running, so that there was no question about whether or not the filament was dry. So, and this is one of the first prints I did with it, and it came out pretty good. Overall, overhangs and everything were reasonably good, although it did sag quite a bit here at the 80 degree angle and the 75 degree angle. There is some stringing obviously here, but bridging pretty good, and overall strength of the piece, it's a lot stronger and a lot stiffer than the previous prints with 8 hours drying. So I thought, okay, we're on to something here. We're definitely getting a better quality print, but this overhanging indicates that we're probably not cooling this properly, or we're printing so fast that it's not getting a chance to cool properly. So the next thing I looked at was print speed. I took the print speed down by 50% and got significantly better overhangs. So the 80% overhangs were pretty good. A lot less drooping, a lot more stable. And again, everything bridging, the shapes are all pretty good. So next thing I looked at was stringing, which we can see here, we have quite a bit of stringing. So I did some stringing tests, and what I found is so in this one here, I made a modification to the retraction, and you can see that by slowing down the retraction, we have quite a rough surface on each of these poles. This is the default setting, which is provided on the profile from eSun, which is 30 millimeters per second. And while we still are getting stringing, I mean, stringing can always be removed, the actual poles themselves are pretty good. And then I kind of moved to 40 millimeter per second retraction, and it's a mess. So what I can say is that the default set by eSun in their profile, 30 millimeters per second, is perfect, and that's the setting to leave it at. So there is a little bit of stringing, but nothing to get upset about. Next up, I did a acceleration tower, and from a material perspective, the print is good all the way along, no particular issues, but you are seeing ghosting, but these are more to do with the printer than the material. So Nothing here particularly to be concerned about. These acceleration points all printed well. Obviously, the faster we went, the more ghosting we got. So, in summary, is it landfill? No, this filament is not landfill. This filament, I think, works well for somebody who has the time to sit down and put the effort in to fine-tune their settings, to dry the product properly and make sure that it's ready for use, and then use the eSun profile for the Bambu Labs printer. If you've got a Bambu Labs printer, if you don't have a Bambu Labs printer, just tune in the filament settings into your own profile for your particular printer. And if you've got the time to put into some test prints, you can fine tune that. You'll actually get a pretty good print. And at half the price of Bambu Labs filament, it's pretty good value. So it's definitely worth consideration. But I would say if you'd like to just stick the filament in your printer and print, and you've got a Bambu Labs printer, then the Bambu Labs filament works better than this. But if you're willing to put the effort in and you're willing to put the time in to fine tune the print, to adjust the settings and to make sure that it's right, and you may have to use a bit of filament in your tests in order to be able to test your settings to make sure that they actually work. And of course, any of these test prints are rubbish, basically. You're not going to use them for anything. So you've got to be careful. Obviously, you've got to weigh the expense of printing out these things, the electricity you're going to use, the filament you're going to use. And you've got to take that into consideration as well when you're comparing the two. So in my experience, Bambu Lab filaments on the Bambu Lab printer with the Bambu Lab profiles, I get better results. But if I'm willing to sit down and tune the eSun, and I'm willing to spend the time and use the filament and the electricity to get the correct settings working, I'll get just as good results from the eSun at half the price. And that really makes sense if you're going to print a lot of stuff and you're going to use a lot of filament. Because once you start using more filament, the price of the eSun really comes into its own, being half the price of the Bambu Lab filaments. I hope you found something useful in this video. I hope you enjoyed the video. And while it's a short video and I haven't gone into a great amount of detail, I hope this has been enough to at least give you an insight into how these products work and whether or not they're worth buying or not, and whether or not they're right for you or not. So with that said, thanks for watching the video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.